Please do let me know. Please say hello so I know who I'm chatting to. I always like to have a bit of engagement with my audience, so I can ask questions and you can ask me questions and we can have a conversation going. I don't know if the weather's equally as miserable where you are today, but it certainly is here. It's very grey, so I've got my lights on and you can see all the back to school craziness behind me. Hi, Natalie. You see, hear me okay? Brilliant. Please jump on, folks, and let me know if you're tuning in. Let me know if the weather's as bad where you are today as it is here in Manchester. It's very grey and rainy, but I guess we can't complain too much after the great summer that we had. But please let me know if you're tuning in. Let me know, say hello, and let me know where you're coming from. Drop me some reactions and thumbs up, heart emojis, just because then more people get the notification that I'm live at the moment. So please, yeah, let me know if you can see this. Then drop me some love hearts, some thumbs up, because then it will flag it to everyone else in the group so they can find the video. So please let me know how you're doing today. Is what the weather's like near you? Is it rainy? Is it raining there, Natalie? Where you are? Like it is here. Let me know. So I've got my indoor lights on today. Got my big light on. I've got my emulating sunlight light to overcome sad. So yeah, let me know. Oh, Natalie says there's a storm last night. There was a bit of delay, I think, on Facebook. So I've just got some messages through. Yeah, the storm last night. Yeah, there was quite stormy here too. Yeah, so if you're all kind of a bit drowned in the rain today during the school run, and busy drying off, don't worry if you're tuning in a bit later, because it will all be recorded and available in the group afterwards, so you can watch on replay. So if you are watching on replay, please hashtag replay. Feel free to ask any questions, because I will check back as well, and help anyone answer anything that you might have. So I'll start by just introducing myself. My name is Sarah Stevens. You will see me on Facebook as Gormley as well, which is my maiden name, mainly because my mother-in-law has the same name as me. So to save confusion, I still go by my maiden name on Facebook. So if you're just wondering about that, that's why I go by the two names. Yeah, so I have over 20 years experience in PR and marketing, working for various different types of companies and brands, from big international brands such as airlines, done all of their PR and brand strategy in the UK, down to some smaller SME size businesses, restaurants, bars, hospitality firms. I've even done events, so big sporting events, all the comms for those, cultural events, theatre festivals, you name it, I've probably done it. And now I actually help entrepreneurs to learn how to do their own PR and marketing. I lectured as an associate lecturer at Manchester Metropolitan University and wrote a sales and marketing course for their management diploma, which was really well received, and with great feedback from the participants, the examination board, and I actually really enjoyed it too. So now I deliver training as well, and actually do it for entrepreneurs and to help you with your businesses. If you are tuning in, please say hello. I know a few of you are watching. It's always good to know who is tuning in. Yeah, I'm a PR expert, and I work and help entrepreneurs to do their own PR marketing. So, who tuning in has done PR before? Has anyone here who's listening done their own PR, does their own PR, maybe has recruited a PR agent or PR company to work on their behalf? Please do let me know in the comments if you have done your own PR before. I'd love to know, and do say hello as well. Let me know whether you've done PR, whether you know what PR is. Do let me know. It's always handy to know the levels that people are at. But if not, I'll start off by explaining. Oh, here we go. Kriti. Hello. I don't know if I've pronounced that correctly. I'm hoping I have. Kriti, I'm a freelance editor and publishing consultant. So good to connect. Hi. Natalie. Yeah. Bit of a delay in people and the comments showing up, I think, as well. Facebook are lagging behind today. Natalie's not done PR before. Great, so we've got a bit of a mix. Please do drop in and say hello. Let me know who's tuning in, because I always like to have a bit of back and forth. And there's opportunities to ask me questions as we're going along. So feel free. That's really good. I love the interaction of these things. So yeah, so anyone who's just tuning in, I've got over 20 years experience in PR and marketing, and I'm now gonna sneeze, so sorry. Oh dear. Right. Yeah, so I help entrepreneurs to do their understand how they can do their own PR and marketing. Quite a lot of people that I come across feel overwhelmed by PR, and they say, oh, I don't really understand it. I can't do it. Kriti says she just knows the theoretical definition of PR, but she's never done it before. Oh, thank you. Bless you, she says. I have an analogy about PR that I really love, that I think it makes it easier for people to understand the difference between, oh, hi Neil, you're a copywriter. Oh, brilliant. I don't think I'll have to tell you all about writing, will I, in this session? I have an analogy that I really love that really helps you to understand what PR is. And it's a little bit of a story, and I probably won't quote it perfectly because I'm just going to ad lib it for you. So forgive me if you know it already and I've completely not done it justice. But yeah, the story I like is that a guy goes on a date. His date's sat there, he comes in and he says, "Hi, I'm Stephen. I'm handsome, I'm successful, I'm a really nice guy, I'm very romantic, I've got lots of money, I drive a Ferrari." And basically he's advertising himself to his date. That's what he's doing. Now, if Stephen says to his date, "Oh, hello, Vanessa. I just love that name. Oh, you're so attractive. I can see immediately you've got very good taste. I just love what you've done with your hair. I can see just from the brief interactions that we've had already, that you're a very intelligent person." He's basically doing marketing. He's telling her exactly what she wants to hear. So he's perfectly marketing to her. Okay, now if she goes off to the toilet, and in the toilet while she's doing her makeup, there's another lady in there that says, "Oh, I see you're here with Stephen. Oh, he's such an amazing guy. You've really hit the jackpot going on a date with him. I went to school with him, so I've known him for years, and his family are amazing. He's such a nice guy. He's so modest. He's got so many friends because we all love him. Just one of the nicest guys you can ever meet. You're so lucky to be on a date with him." Well, that is PR. That's someone else telling the person you want to influence how great you, your product, your book, your service is. And that is worth so much more. Someone else, a third party, shouting out about your business, service, whoever. Okay? So hopefully that makes a bit more sense now in terms of what PR is. PR, I know, like Chrissy says, she knows the theoretical definition of PR. So the theoretical definition is PR is public relations, which in this day and age doesn't mean a whole of a lot to people. My definition, I prefer to call it personal relationships. Because for me, PR, you're managing those personal relationships that surround yourself, your business, your book, all of those things. You're managing all those relationships, the relationships with your customers, with your staff, with Joe blogs on the streets, with influencers, with stakeholders. So if you've written a book, it might be the publisher, it might be your editor, it might be whoever it is that's managing all of those relationships, personally managing them all, so that they're saying the right things about you. So who here has done PR before? Anyone? If I said, who here has asked someone to write them a recommendation or write them a referral or write them a review, who here has done that? Anyone? Let me know. Oh, Kaz says, thank you for sharing. Yeah, I hope that makes sense, Kaz. Please let. Yes, I am. Yeah. So great, because quite a lot of people feel when you first talk to them about PR, feel really overwhelmed by it. They don't really understand it. And mostly when I do face-to-face trainings, I get people at the start of the training to, oh, Kaz used to be a PR ambassador for Sainsbury's. Oh, how amazing, Kaz. Yeah, so usually at the start of a training session, when it's a phys in physical person one, I ask people at the very start to put their hands up if they currently do PR. And not many people put their hands up. So then I explain the definition and what PR is. And then I ask them again. And the majority of people then suddenly put their hands up because most of us have asked people for recommendations or reviews. And done that, and you don't even realize that actually you're doing PR because you're getting other people to refer or recommend you. So that other person could be the media, it could be a press review, it could be an article about you, it could be someone doing a news story. Unless you've paid them to do it, in which case it's an advertorial because you've written it and paid for that space to go in there, and then it comes under advertising. If you haven't paid them to write it, you might have asked them to write it, but if you've not paid for them to do it, then that's PR because it's earned media, we call it. Hi, Claire. Thanks for saying hello. If you've just tuned in, please say hello. And you can watch on catch up. If you're watching back on replay, please hashtag replay. I'll check back and answer any questions you've got as well. So I hope that definition of PR has kind of helped people a little bit more, and hopefully that it'll help with the overwhelm because you're already doing PR. So how can you be overwhelmed about something you're already doing and you were already doing it without realizing you were doing it? Okay. So now if PR is just one of the components of marketing. So it's one of the tools of marketing. So marketing and PR are intrinsically linked together. And most people quite often mistakenly do PR as an add-on or nice to have, or even separately before they've even really worked out a PR, a marketing strategy, which is wrong because it's one of the tools of PR. So one of the tools of marketing. So in order for PR to be successful, you need to have the marketing foundations in place first. So you need to know who your target audience is, who your target customer is, who your target reader is if you're looking to promote a book. You need to know as much about them as possible. It could be their demographic, it could be the certain age bracket, it could be can't even speak now. Geographical, so it could be where they live within a particular region or area. It could be they have a particular job or a hobby, or you should be able to define who your target customer, reader, user, whoever is. And the more clearly you can define and niche them, the better, because then that obviously feeds into all your marketing, and your tone of voice. And as writers here, you'll understand about tone of voice, and you'll be able to then write for your target audience. And then when you come to do the PR, because you've got the foundations there, the PR becomes somewhat easier. So if you know who your target market is, you then think about what media they consume. So your target audience, think about, do they watch TV? Do they have Netflix? What's the favorite Netflix series? Do they read papers? Do they consume news content online? Do they listen to podcasts? Do they work from home like me? Do they commute to work to the office every day? And if so, do they drive there? And if they drive there, do they listen to the radio? Do they listen to a podcast in the car? Do they get the train to work? Do they get the tram to work? Do they, in which case, then do they pick up the free newspaper on the train or tram and read that? Or do they take a book? Do they have a Kindle? Do they listen to podcasts? You get kind of the idea that I'm going with here. You need to know as much about what media they consume as possible. And it's possible to Google, and once you know who your target market is, you can Google and find out the readerships of different publications so you can kind of extrapolate then which ones are more likely to read. But the more information you can glean about what your target audience do, what they like to read, what they like to consume. And I've had people say to me, oh, but if they watch Netflix or if they like to watch curry, of an evening, I can't afford to pay for TV advertising. So how is that useful to me? That's not useful to me at all. But actually it is, because when you're thinking of PR angles and hooks, or even social media posts and stories, knowing that your target audience will be watching Coronation Street at a certain time on a certain night, and therefore, there might suddenly be a big climatic storyline. Well, you can use that as part of your conversation. There might be a media hook, and there might be a similarity between your book that you've written and a storyline in their favourite soap, and you can hook that in. It has is PR is more credible than ads. Yes, it is, because it's seen as earned media, and because it's seen as being written by someone else, it's far more valuable. We pay more attention to someone else recommending something to us and saying that's brilliant. That's why celebrities earn so much money for endorsing different products and brands, because We're more likely to buy it because they've said it's great, even if they don't use it, than we are than just seeing an advert without the celebrity or the known person recommending it. And that's how multi-level marketing MLM companies work. It's all referrals and recommendations by people who know other people. And since the dawn of time, people have listened to other people. That's how we've evolved as a species. We've learnt from each other, and that's not going to go away. So it's really important to know what your customers are reading and consuming, and then you know which publications you want to get coverage in, because you want to read about them to read about you in that publication. Or if they're listening to certain podcasts, if that podcast has guests people on, maybe that's where you want to be. Maybe you want to be on in interviewed in that podcast. If you're going to do some ads, maybe you want to be really targeted. Maybe you know your entire target audience listens regularly to a set podcast. They don't have guest interviewers on it, but so maybe you can advertise on that podcast, and that's one way to reach them. Maybe. And again, for your social media as well, it's really important to know what social media, if any social media, your target audience use. Because I've had one client in the past go, "Oh, I use Facebook all the time. Social media really doesn't work for me." And then we drill down to who their target market was, and they weren't on Facebook. They hated Facebook. Their target market were on LinkedIn. And actually, once she switched her entire strategy to LinkedIn, it worked, and it's she started getting results. Similar with PR, I remember what chatting to a big client who'd spent thousands and thousands of pounds paying for the services of one of the best PR agencies in the country, who's multi award winning, really huge, so it cost them a fortune. They said, "We did a year's campaign with them. The PR agency had loads of success for us. They got us in national publications. The press coverage was worth millions of pounds. Had millions of viewers see it or readership. But we didn't see any movement on our bottom line. On our number of leads coming in, our sales didn't budge." And whilst yes, you can't guarantee with PR that there'll be some movement there, when I tell you that, because I sat down with them and said, "Well, show me, tell me who your target market is." And so they sat down, and they were a company whose target market were students. Okay? Their target market they were selling to were students. They were the decision makers, the purchasers of their services. So then I said, "Great, okay. So what coverage did the PR agency get for you?" And they said, "Well, they got us in Forbes magazine, in the Financial Times. We were in all the business sections of all the regional newspapers. We got into the business section of the Times newspaper. We were on some podcasts that were interviewing CEOs and business leaders. Can anyone tell me why? What went wrong with this, and why they didn't get any? See any positive effects on their business? Anyone? Anyone tell me why that didn't work for them? Why? And because they were telling me PR doesn't work. PR is a disaster. It's a waste of money. PR really, really doesn't work. And then I had to sit down and explain to them why it actually didn't work for them. Because yeah, Kaz says wrong target audience, Natalie Roberts, students wouldn't read or listen to that. No, exactly. Now you might think it's not brain surgery to realise that, is it? But when you think one of the biggest PR agencies didn't realise that, didn't accurately find out from the client what they wanted to achieve, and therefore where they needed to be placed. That wasn't, there was just disconnect there. So this is why it's really, really important not to treat PR as an extra little fluffy, nice to have thing. Now, if that company had said to the PR agency when they briefed them, look, we know that our target customer doesn't read Forbes or the Financial Times, but what actually we want to do is we want to sell our business in the next 2 years, and so we want people who buy other businesses and invest in other businesses to know who we are. Then, actually, that brief, they would have answered it because that is the target market for that PR campaign. So the PR campaign might have a slightly different target market if they're looking to sell their business or whatever. So hopefully that makes sense to you, that you need to have clear objectives for why you want to do PR, and what you want the outcomes to be. And it's with PR as well, it's not a super, super quick win by any stretch of the imagination. So it's not like you'll suddenly get press coverage and then that's it. You don't need to do anything else. It'll your business will sell itself, your book will sell itself. That's not the case. Everything needs to be consistent. There needs to be a consistent message across all your channels. So I teach consistent messaging across all of your meet marketing strategy, so all of your writing on your social media, on your website, on your PR outreach, all of that needs to be consistent. There needs to be a consistent brand image, and the same goes if you're trying to promote a book. So there needs to be a consistent brand image. So your book needs to be reflective of you and of the brand and what you're trying to push. Now your book might be a slightly different brand than, say, if you've got a business or whatever, it might be a slightly different style of you and everything else, but everything surrounding that needs to be consistent. Consistent messaging, consistent imagery, consistent, 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 because I had a client who wanted to get, had been trying to get in the media for her. She had a business that was going for 7 years. She'd been trying to get into the media for about 5 years. She'd wanted to get into the Metro newspaper. So for 5 years, she'd constantly tried to speak to the editor, sent information through, got no response, no nothing. And so I worked, came on to one of my courses. It was a 6 week course of New Biz to PR Whiz, which is now actually available as a download. So you can watch it and do that course anytime. But she did this 6 week course with me. And at the start, she'd explain this to me, and we worked through it, and we looked at her entire marketing strategy for her business, and there was some disconnects between how she was coming across on a website in terms of the writing and also the imagery, and how she was coming across on a social media. There was no kind of tally. On the social media, she was very friendly and outgoing and happy and caring and everything, and her website was very corporate, quite cold, very corporate language, very businessy, and not her at all, and not in keeping with the brand image that she wanted. It consistent branding and consistent messaging across everything, and with the wording for the outreach to the Metro that she really wanted to do. She outreached to them, and this time the Metro will have cl the before they respond to anyone, they will have done the due diligence and had a little look at the website, had a look at the social media, and it was all consistent. So they went on the website and they got the same kind of feel, that they did from her email, from the social media, and that consistency meant that she got the coverage in Metro by week 4 of my course. So it's really, really important to be consistent with your wording and everything else. And I know I may be preaching to the converted here because you're all writers, but it's really, really important. The words do matter. So it's really important to be consistent across all the different platforms. And especially if you're trying to promote a book, that's really, really important. And in order to promote your book, you need to, when I've said that you obviously need to be in the right media that your target audience are going to read, that's great. Now, the target media that you identify that you want to go into, it's really important for you to know them. So it might be media that you're not that familiar with, maybe you don't read regularly. You need to start reading it. So you need to start reading and consuming the media that you want to be featured by for at least 2 or 3 weeks before you then outreach to them. Because you need to know what they are writing about. Will they write about you? If they will write about you and your story, what might be the right angle to go for? Also by reading their publications, you'll get a feel for which journalist is writing about the things that you want them to write about you. You'll have a view and a feel for the recent articles that they've done. And therefore, if your book, say, just grasping at straws here, but if your book is I don't know, about the love of a dog, your pet dog. I'm just making this up, you can tell. If it's about dogs, for instance, and they've done, it's a journalist who writes about pets and animals and things like that, and they've recently written about something very similar, then you might think, oh, actually, the odds are they might not write about that again, so maybe I need to think of a different hook for them or a different angle that I can go in with so that they'll write about me. Because so many people send a story through and go, oh, I've got this great story for you, without having read that publication and without realizing that that journalist wrote something very similar the day before, and that journalist won't even deem you relevant to respond to because it's clear that you haven't read their publication and you don't know their publication, so they'll just ignore you, and you won't know why they've not taken your story angle, why they've not chosen to write about you. You won't get the feedback probably, but if you read their publication, you'll know that it's because they already wrote about that. So actually, you might have been better going in with a slightly different angle or a slightly different hook. So it's really important to think about that publication, the journalist, why would their readership care about you and your story or whatever? Why should they want to write about you? Why are their readers, is their readership going to be bothered? So think about the story of you and your book. What is that hook? It might be that you wrote your book during lockdown while you were on leave from furlough from your business. So there might be an angle there. You might have written it on a beach in Barbados because you took advantage of the work for yourself, work from anywhere thing that they did a few years ago, where you could just go and work remotely from a beach in Barbados. Whatever that story is, there might be a hook there of how you wrote the book. There might be a hook about what the book is about and the theme and things like that. You just need to pull out what the media is going to be interested in. The fact you've just launched this book isn't story in itself, unless you're David Beckham. Then the media's going to be interested if he, brings out a new toothpaste or whatever, they're going to be interested. So you need to find that hook, that unique hook, and that reason they might have for writing about you. Does that all make sense? Has anyone got any questions they want to ask me at this stage? Please ask away. Let me know. If that all makes sense, please let me know. And I'm going to leave you with some top tips of easy wins of PR that you can do straight away and get results. Because what I like to help people do is ditch the overwhelm by giving them easy stepping stones to doing their own PR and marketing. I hope this has helped you all. Please let me know if it makes sense, if you've got any questions. Kaz, yes, all clear to me, and I've sent you a DM about something. Ooh, that's exciting, Kaz. I will have a read of that after this live. I'm very, very curious. Yeah, please let me know if you've got any questions. As I say, if you're watching this on replay, please hashtag replay. Let me know you're watching. Let me know if you've got any questions about anything. In the event description for this, I did include a link to a free community I have, which is PR and marketing for independent entrepreneurs, where I do quite a lot of free trainings. There's free content and help in there, explain different things. I also have a free challenge that I will include a link in the comments after this too. I have a free challenge, perfect PR challenge, that begins next week on the 12th. And we'll run for 3 days. On the fourth day, there will be a mastermind, of which the title hasn't been decided because I'm asking people in the group to vote for what they'd most like that to be. So feel free to vote for that as well. That will be going out today, asking for votes. And yeah, so I hope you might join me. Oh, Claire says "Pearly Whites and Stripes" by David Beckham. Yeah, Natalie makes a lot of sense. Great. But yeah, hopefully, I'd love to see a load of you in my free challenge next week. Perfect PR, where I actually deep dive a little bit more into how you can use PR to attract your perfect match, i.e. perfect customer. So yeah, I hope you can join me for that, and I'll also be announcing my new PR, perfect PR course that will start beginning of October, at the end of the challenge. But I know loads of people who did the challenge last time I ran it at the start of the year, and the feedback was from those who had that actually didn't go on to do any of my paid things, that they got so much out of just the free challenge that it really helped them with the business and helped them to get their head in the right frame of mind for doing PR. So feel free to join that challenge and get lots of free learning and support from that. Feel free to join my group, and PM me any questions directly if you want, or pop any questions in my group, because quite a lot of people in there have done a lot of my courses, so they might actually be able to help you out as well before I can even get to your question. So yeah, thank you for having me. So some quick easy wins that I will share with you now is, to number one, if you don't already have a system of asking people for reviews and recommendations of your books, your services, your business, whatever, start doing it. Start asking for those reviews and recommendations. If it makes life easier, set it up on the bottom of your email signature so that it automatically goes out when you're emailing people. So you don't even have to think about it, that it just automatically goes out with all your emails. That's one first top tip for PR, because once you start getting regular reviews and referrals, then brilliant. The other one is, if you don't already have a Google My Business account set up, for your business, your brand, your book, whatever, get one set up. Because, oh my God, At first, you'll set it all up, link to your website, where to buy your book, whatever. You'll set it up and you'll think, you might ask people to review you on there, get Google reviews, put the link in your email signatures, whatever. You probably won't see any benefit from it for a few months. Then, all of a sudden, because you've been asking people to write reviews on there, you maybe post some blog posts into the news feature on it or whatever, all of a sudden, momentum and consistency will take over and the SEO will start working for you and you'll start getting people coming through your Google My Business. But again, it's consistency and it's doing something so often it becomes habit. And that's what PR is, it's consistency. If you speak to any top PR person, very few of them will get success, PR success, straight off the back from a journalist or email. You have to ch chase and hound them. You have to be persistent and consistent in order to get the results. That's what you need to do. Okay, so make sure all your messaging's correct, all your wording's correct, you've got your strategy, and then be consistent and persistent is my secret for success. But make sure you do that good research at the start. So hopefully those tips will help you. Yeah, watch for it from the start, Louise. Nice to see you here. Claire, yeah. Go back and watch from the start. If you've got any questions, hashtag replay and ask them when you watch it back. Happy to jump on and answer any questions anyone has. And yeah, thank you. And hope to see you in my free challenge and in my group. I'll share a link to the free challenge in the comments here for you so you can join that. That would be amazing to see you in there and to connect with you from here. And feel free to DM me if you've got anything that you want to ask but you don't want to share with everyone else. That's fine. And yeah, thanks for having me. I really appreciate you inviting me in here, Natalie. It's great to chat to your audience. Yeah. So, thank you. Have a great Tuesday, and hopefully, speak to you again soon. Thank you.